All right, welcome to Cooking with Scott. I've been planning on doing cooking videos for a while, and Blue Apron, in the most recent shipment I got, sent me a recipe with a contest attached to make a video of you cooking. So I guess that's a good excuse as any to actually start this. So the recipe is spice-rubbed pork with sweet red onion and black beans, and that's what we're going to cook today. First, let's talk about this contest. So the contest is something related to some cooking TV show. It came with a cardboard microphone over here. I don't need that. I have a real microphone. But so it's, let's see, Bravo's Top Chef, whatever. You can win cooking lessons with the person who won the show, Brooke Williamson. So that's pretty good, right? Win some cooking lessons, especially when you're not good at cooking like me. You can also win 6 free months of Blue Apron. That's a crazy good prize, right? That's way good. And you can also win a round trip flight and 2-night stay in New York City, which is kind of okay. Great. So let's, I guess, cook this thing here. Boom. Okay. Step one, check the ingredient list after you drop it on the floor. All right, ingredient list. 1, pork roast. I has it. Black beans. They gave those to me also. 2 cloves of garlic. I'm going to use 3 cloves because that's how I do. 1 onion. I got the onion, the red onion, the best kind. Some cilantros. Sorry, friends who can't eat cilantros. I can eat it. All right, knickknacks. Apple cider vinegar. Check. Honey. They put the honey in this cardboard thing, actually. I had put the knickknacks in the fridge, and this honey was way hard. And I was glad I prepared in advance, so now the honey is soft. I softened it up with some warmth. Roast pork spice blend. Ooh, what's in the spice blend? Chili, cumin, garlic powder, coriander, and ground up chipotle pepper. All right, pretty good. Butter. Butter. And brown sugar. Woo! All right, that's it. Not a lot of ingredients going on here. This should be easy. Okay, step 1. Preheat the oven to 475 degrees. I like to preheat my oven way in advance usually, and I got a pizza stone in there. It makes everything sort of nice and even. You don't get the hot spots and whatnot. Wash and dry the fresh produce. Don't really need to wash the onion. It's got an onion skin we're going to throw out. Not going to wash the garlic. Oh, I guess we could wash these cilantros. That's a good idea. It's a nice paper towel. I've been using paper towel a lot more when cooking stuff since getting Blue Apron. I used to only use paper towel for like cleaning things. But now I use it for like patting down wet things, you know, foods and whatnot. And it's pretty useful because it's not, you know, filthy and disgusting like your dish towels are. All right. All right. Oop. All right, we got some dry cilantros going on over there. Recycle this biz. Into the recycling with you. Okay, next step. Peel and have the onion. Onion. My cutting skills are not like pro level, but you know, since I keep cooking a lot more than I used to before Blue Apron, I cook like, you know, when I get it, I cook 3 times a week. My cutting has improved significantly. You know, I'm not like chop, 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 but you know, I'm better than other people I know. So they want me to have the onion this way? Or they want to have it this way. I think it's this way they want me to have it. Taff. Also, getting a fancy knife really makes cutting a lot more fun, you know, even if you're not any good at it. You know, especially when it's sharp, it's a lot less effort too. Even if you have old knives, you can get them sharpened. I saw a great video on YouTube. This guy, he bought like the cheapest knife at the dollar store, and then he sharpened it using like 5 different whetstones, and it became the sharpest, crazy knife you've ever seen. It was so cool. I always put my smelly food in like a separate place from my regular trash. That way, my regular trash doesn't stink. I think this onion has like a spot on it that looks kind of gross. I'm going to cut that off of there. Okay, get out of here, stinky, slightly rotten onion part. Okay, peel and halve the onions. Small dice, 1/2. Okay, and cut the remaining half into inch-thick pieces. So let's do cut the remaining half into inch-thick pieces first. That's about an inch, right? I guess that's what they mean. Yeah, that's what they mean. I like to have all these bowls around when I'm cooking. It's like I prepare all the ingredients and put them in little bowls. So we'll put this, well, this can go in here, the inch thick onion pieces. There you go. And then what's the other half? Small dice the other half. All right, small dicing. I'm not the best at small dicing, but you know, it'll be fine. See, you get to this part of the onion and it starts to, you know, slide down toward your hand. So I like to turn it around so if the knife slips, it doesn't slip into my fingers and kill me. Some chef is probably watching like, oh my God, your knife technique, you're going to kill somebody. But I've been doing all right. I've never cut myself with a knife, unlike some people. Some people holding the camera back there maybe, you know, had to be driven to the hospital late at night and waited for hours.
Only once.
With bad kitchen knife techniques. All right. That's not happening. It'd be a great video for YouTube, though. Good thing we got the cameras rolling. Maybe I should cut myself just to get mad views, right? They'd be like, oh my God, dude cuts himself while making cooking video from, you know, Blue Apron. Oh, man. No. Kitchen safety and cleanliness is like the most important, everybody. All right. Is that, you think that's small diced? Or do I need more? Is that medium diced? I'm not sure. You know, I see all the other chefs do it on TV. They have this technique where, like, they, like, cut it without cutting all the way through and then get it from the side. I'll cut it a little bit more. No onion crying. Pretty good onion. No crying action going on here. No crying action. Okay. A knife over there where it won't cut me. I like to bring the bowl up onto the cutting board when I move the food into it. That way, any food that you drop is on the cutting board. I used to not do that. I used to like have the bowl next to the cutting board. And then what would happen is I would drop food all over the counter and the floor when it was going between the cutting board and the bowl. And that didn't work out too well. All right, onion step complete. Now I'm starting to cry a whole bunch. All right, peel and roughly chop the garlics. So now I'm crying with the stupid onion. Oh my God. I already finished the onion part. All right, garlic part. So my friends like to have garlic presses and their babies. And I see pro chefs, what they do, they just like, bam, and the garlic is mushed and everything's perfect. I can't do it that way. But this is what I do, is I cut off the root part of the garlic, like so, because no one wants to eat that. If you found that in your food, you'd get like a refund at the restaurant, right? Got to move this bowl away, but my knife is hitting it. That's dangerous. Okay. Throw those things out so we don't accidentally eat them. Get out of here. Yeah. Okay, and we take each garlic and we just sort of go, nyeh, nyeh, smashing. Oh, and that gets the skin off. Look, the skin just went, wee, ran away. Doesn't like being smashed. Oh, we should tell our hydraulic press guy to like hydraulic press a garlic to the other side of the world. So scared of pressing. Yeah. Oh, goodbye, garlic skins. Yeah, I don't know why. It's like you just press on the garlic a little bit, and the skin like completely detaches, right? But if you were to like try to peel the skin off, even if you had good fingernails, good luck with that, right? It's so stuck on there. Anyway, get a little tiny bowl to put the garlics in. Let's put it over there. Roughly chop the garlic. Okay, so we don't need to like, you know, go crazy and mince the garlic. We're just roughly chopping here. Even though that's probably slicing, someone's yelling at me that's not roughly chopping, but deal with it. That's how I know. That looks roughly chopped. All right, roughly chopped garlic into the bowl you go. You got some onion skins in there. Oh well, won't kill you. Yeah. Yeah. That's another reason I use 3 more garlics than they tell you to, in case, you know. All right, Drain and rinse the beans. I need a bowl to put the beans in. Oh, here they are. I took them out already. I do need the can opener, though. And I need a little bean rinser. There we go. Okay. You know, when I was young, I didn't really eat a lot of beans ever. It was very, you know, we didn't have beans in the house. My mom didn't make anything with beans in it that I can remember. Maybe some soup would have beans in it, I guess. But these days, like, I like beans a ton. Like, way a lot. It might even be when the barbecue comes to the city every year, there's a guy, he has these barbecue baked beans. Those could be, like, my favorite food there is. I think this guy's a little small. Let's get a bigger guy. There we go. Drain and rinse them beans. Blorp. Yeah. Wise to go with the bigger. Got to rinse this out so we can recycle it properly. These are not barbecue baked beans, however, they're black beans. But black beans still good. Still good. All right, those are rinsed. Drain and rinse the beans. Into a bowl you go. Okay, what else we got here? Finely chop the cilantro leaf and stem. Come here. Oof. Well, at least we get to the leaf. Oh, there's some extra garlics here. What are you doing on my knife? Getting there. It said what? Finely chop? I'm finely chopping. So fine. Oh yeah, it smells like cilantro now, big time. I do appreciate the fresh cilantro versus the, you know, pre-existing dried up cilantro. You know, it actually works. It actually tastes like cilantro, unlike, you know, the dried up stuff, a lot of times, like, it doesn't taste like anything at all. It's like, why'd you even put it in there? Okay, that's enough cilantro. The rest of it's sort of stuck. All right, that is the end of the ingredient preparation phase. Let's clean my knife off here. Nice, clean kitchen action. All right. Next step, searing the pork. Ooh, getting a meat action going on now. All right. Pork. It's a pretty nice piece of pork's here. All right. Line a sheet pan. We're not even doing even though it says sear the pork, we're doing something else first. Line a sheet pan with aluminum foil. I got one of those. Sheet pan. Foil. Line the sheet pan with foil. Huh, why is the sheet pan exactly the right size for this foil? How did that happen? Done. Pat the pork dry with paper towel. Oh. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's kind of wet in there. I also wisened up a lot. I used to like take meat right out of the fridge and try to cook it. But now I let it get to room temperature first, and that seems to be a lot better. I think that's what you're supposed to do. It makes cooking a lot easier. It's annoying that these bags they give you don't have like a spot to tear them open. Nope, we got it. Okay. Paper towel. Mm-mm. All right. Padding it with paper towel. Sides with salt, pepper, and spice blend. Okay. Oh, it's padded. Hey. Let's get a plate. There we go. Salt. Turn it over. Salt again. Peppers. Yeah. and spice blend. Oh, I've already put the scissor in the sink. No. All right. My hands have pork on them. I should probably wash them. I'll get a different scissor. It's a good thing I have two scissors. This one is not a meat-touching scissor, but this is a spice, so it's fine. Okay. All right. Now we got the spice. We can... Ooh, that's a lot of spice. Maybe that's too much. That's okay. Turn it over. There's plenty. There's so much spice in here. Season with salt and pepper. Oh, no, wrong one. Ah, okay. And the spice blend. All right. Make sure we get the spice blend all over. Because this is supposed to be spice-rubbed pork, right? So let's do some rubbing. Rubbing. Doesn't say to do this, but I can tell. That's what I'm supposed to do. Right? We don't want to waste any of that. That's the part that's going to taste good, right? The spicy blend. All right. That seems spice rubbed enough to me. Okay. In the large pan, heat a teaspoon of olive oil on medium high until hot. Add the pork and cook, turning occasionally for 3 to 5 minutes. All right. Oh, our oven is preheated. How about that? That's nice. Got my little thing there. 1 teaspoon. All right, they said in the pan, 1 teaspoon of olive oil. Where'd my olive oil go? I have my olive oil. All right. All these recipes from Blue Apron need like olive oil, salt, and pepper like all the time. So I always have those three things on my counter. Meniscus? Okay. Olive oil. Fire. We got fire going on now. Okay. I know that my stovetop is kind of really hot with the gas, so I, even though it says medium high would be like number 8 down here. I put it on like number 3 or 4, which isn't even the midpoint. Medium is 5 on this thing, but it'll be fine. All right. We're going to add the pork and cook for 3 to 5 minutes, browning on all sides, and then transfer to the sheet pan. Okay. Now we play the waiting game. I don't know if you're supposed to do this, but I like to use my wooden spoon to spread the oil around. I guess it just gives you something to do during the waiting time. I don't know if that's good or bad. Should I be doing this? Maybe it's a mistake that I do this. It's also, I guess, sort of an OCD kind of thing, right? It's like I need the oil to be evenly dispersed in the pan. I can't have the oil all in one blob, right? It doesn't seem right. The way to test to see if the oil is the right temperature is get some cold water on your finger. Come on, cold. And then sort of go flick. And see, it didn't go tss. It just sort of went meh, so it's not hot enough yet. When it goes tss, it'll be good. But now that we already tossed some water in there, we can just wait for that water to go tss, and we'll be okay. Oh, I think that oil might be ready over there. The noises. Oh, yeah, it's ready. All right. We'll grab a little grabber. Come here, you. Yep. Yep. This is what happens when you live in the city. You don't have drawers. Okay. It said, occasionally, 3 to 5 minutes. Oh, turning occasionally 3 to 5 minutes or until browned on all sides. All right. So get you in there. We'll set the timer for 5 minutes. And we'll turn it, get some fan going on. A little more fire. Looking good. All right, turning occasionally. We don't want to turn it too much. That would be probably not good. Constant turning. Leave the brown bits of or fond in the pan, and then move this to the sheet pan. Okay. So 5 minutes from now, we're going to sheet pan this guy. See? All right, let's flip. Flipping! Oh, seems good. Smell good? Smells good. Let's get some oil moving around in there.
There's not a lot of it.
So I don't know if I should sear the sides also, right?
I do.
Let's see what it says. Turning occasionally or until browned on all sides. Ah. So that includes the, oops, I cut some of it. See people in restaurants, like, you know, using these tong-type things all the time. But it's surprising. Like, I never owned one until relatively recently when I thought, hey, I'll go buy one of these things, right? It wasn't a standard equipment in, like, my mom's kitchen, this kind of tong. We got 1 minute left. We're only searing right now, right? So it's obviously not fully cooked all the way through. I'm pretty sure that's going to happen in the oven. I'm very precise with the timing. I think that, like, real chefs just look and they know. But I can't do that, so I have to really trust in the timing. So it's good that these recipes always tell you, you know, they give you a time. Precise time. It makes it more like baking and less like cooking. Just follow the instructions. Don't fall. You got this. All right. Looking pretty good. Nice and poofy, I guess. I don't know if that's good or not. I'm sure it will be edible after it goes in the oven. All right. Turn that fire off and get this guy onto the foil. Looking good. All right. Leaving any brown pan, transfer one side of the prepared sheet pan. All right. Place the sliced onion, in a medium bowl. Got my medium. Let's move this out of the way for now. You go chill over there, pork man. All right. Medium bowl. Done. Drizzle with olive oil, salt, and pepper. Drizzling. That's a drizzle. Salt. Pepper. Okay. Transfer it to the other side. Season with salt and pepper. Toss thoroughly to coat. Let's break these apart. I think pretty sure that's what you're supposed to do, right? These aren't supposed to all be attached to each other. Yeah. What's wrong with you, onion? Okay. Oh, that's why. Tossing. Usually, I used to, like, be afraid to, like, toss stuff with my hands. I would try to toss with, like, you know, a spoon or tongs or something. But you didn't get the good toss and that complete coating when you do it that way. So nowadays, I just use my hands without fear. And I get some really good tossing going on. Okay. Transfer to the other side of the sheet pan. Okay. I guess you're going in the oven, too, I guess, Mr. Onion. There we go. Nope. Some extra onion. Okay. Boop. To the other side of the sheet pan. Roast 20 to 22 minutes. Oh, man, we're going to be in there for a while. It's oven time. So the oven's nice and preheated. In you go. See, I got my pizza stone in there. And we're going to go. Oh, not that many minutes. 21 minute. All right. Oh, an instant read thermometer in the pork should register 145 degrees. Good thing I have an instant read thermometer. I'll use that in 20 minutes. Remove from the oven, transfer the roasted pork to a cutting board, let it rest for at least 5 minutes. Drizzle the onion with half the vinegar. Okay, so none of those things are going to happen right now. While the pork and onion roast, this is what we want to do. In a small pot. Okay, so I think we're going to need this frond here. We don't need this, though. Let's get my small pot. Oop. Move the pan over. Swapping. Okay. In a small pot, heat the butter until it's melted. Where's the butter? There it is. So what are we going to... Oh, we're going to be caramelizing the diced onion. That sounds fun and delicious. Let's do that. Boop. Butter. Okay. Heat the butter until melted. It's going to melt quickly. Let's get a different wooden spoon besides this one. New wooden spoon. Okay. As soon as the butter's melted, add this onion, salt and pepper. Go for 3 to 4 minutes. We're going to need a different timer because the oven timer is using is occupied. Good thing I have these extra timers going on. Wait for the butter to melt here. Mmm, butter. The secret to delicious food is butter, garlic, and sugar. Those are the three delicious ingredients. If you're not using one of those ingredients in a food, there's something wrong with that food. What kind of delicious food doesn't have at least one of those, right? The most delicious thing is butter sugar. That's how you make a cookie. You can melt. You can do it. I'm always paranoid when melting butter that I'm going to burn the butter, which is the worst thing ever. So I watch it pretty closely, even though I probably don't have to. Oh, man, butter and onion. Oh, this is going to be great. All right. Butter is now melted. Add the onion, salt, and pepper. 3 to 4 minutes. This is why it's great to put everything into separate bowls like this. Salt. Pepper. A little more fire. 3 to 4 minutes. Tick, 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 tick. I've only got like 3 timers here. I don't think I've ever needed more than 2. But sometimes you go to a ramen place and it's crazy. They have like a whole grid of timers for all the different ramens for made for different people. So I always using multiple timers. Cook stirring occasionally. All right, well, that was one occasion. Let's stop stirring. We'll wait for another occasion to stir again. I'm never sure how frequently to stir when it says frequently, occasionally. Does frequently mean do it without stopping? Like, don't stop stirring? That would be stirring constantly. So stirring frequently is less than constantly, and occasionally is even less than frequently. All I know is I got butter onion. Oh, yeah. Butter onion. All right. So once this cooking is done, we're going to go for the brown sugar and the half cup of water are coming into play. Got the brown sugar ready. Oof. Maybe some stirring should happen. Oh, it smells way good. Can you smell that over there?
I can smell that over there.
Yes, okay. Maybe I should just make butter onion on my own, right? You don't need a recipe to make butter onion. I mean, you could just put this butter onion probably right in a hamburger and be like, yeah, upgrade from just regular onion. And then we're going to put brown sugar and water. Oh, come on. Sugar and butter. What'd I tell you? Butter sugar. And there's garlic waiting on the side. We got about a minute left on this butter onion. Why don't we take this opportunity to peek in the oven with the oven light? Ooh-doo-doo-doo. Doesn't look like much is happening in there. I see some bubbling going on underneath the pork. I see a little burnination on the tips of the onions, but that's about it. Turn the oven light off. All right, I think it's just about time to go for the sugar and the water on the onion here. Okay, let's do it. Should we put the water or the sugar in first? Let's see. Add the brown sugar and half a cup of water. I guess the order doesn't matter, but they did say sugar first. So in goes the sugar. And in goes the water. Ooh. Ah, stirring. Okay. 11 to 13 minutes. All right, timer. You're getting reset there. And this stir would be an occasional stir. Again, not a frequent or constant stir, but occasional. And you stir it when the occasion strikes. All right, we got our onion and pork in the oven. We got our butter, sugar, onion on the stove. Is there anything else to happen here? Ah, there is. While the onion caramelizes, make some bean action. Okay. So we gotta go over here. Let's actually see one here. While the onion caramelizes, heat the pan of reserve frond on medium until hot. Ah, okay. Why don't we do this? Let's put that there, and let's swap these two pans. Nope. Without burning myself, very carefully. Nope. Simply because we're making a video, we want the pan that we're actually doing something with to be in the shot better. And so we got the onions on the side. Okay. All right, we're heating the reserve fond. If the pan seems dry, add some olive oil. All right, we'll add a little bit. Because the pan does seem a little dry. Okay, there we go. Add the garlic. Season with salt and pepper. Cook, stirring constantly. 30 seconds to 1 minute. Okay, so garlic, salt and pepper on the garlic. We got our third wooden spoon here. And we're gonna roll for 30 seconds to a minute. Okay. Start constant stirring. Then we're gonna add the beans, salt and pepper, 3 to 4 minutes. Still got 13 minutes left on the pork. Still got 10 minutes left on the water onion over there. The timing seems pretty good to me. The onion should be done just before the pork is ready. Okay. That seems about good on this garlic. Add the garlic, sea salt, 30 seconds a minute. Add the beans. Here we go, beans. Bean town. Salt and pepper on the bean. Okay. Stirring occasionally 3 to 4 minutes or until the beans begin to break down. All right, our third timer is coming into the action here. You could always use a timer on your phone too if you need more timers, if you don't have a bunch. Bean. Garlic bean. All right. I guess we also got to keep an eye and see. I don't know what beans look like when they break down. Are the skin's going to come off and such? Is that how it works? Oh, yeah. You can actually see some of them are breaking down a little bit. They're, like, popped open. Okay. Let's look at the picture. If you look at the picture, you can tell how the beans are supposed to look when they're done, right? You can see that they're sort of like, they're not quite refried beans where they're super mush. But they're definitely much less intact than they are here. So we definitely got some work to do on these beans. Okay. Once they've broken down, we're going to go with the honey, remaining vinegar. Oh, no. I forgot to add the vinegar to the onion that's in the stove. I messed up. The onion that's in the stove should have had some vinegar on it. Oh, well. That's a shame. I messed up. Anyway, mistakes like that happen. We're going to add the honey, the remaining vinegar, so half. and a half a cup of water. Oh, I need another half a cup of water. Crap. Water. Water. Okay, still got time. This one's getting closer. All right, honey, half the vinegar, and the water. So I get the ingredients that I'm going to be using soon right next to me. Am I stirring too much? It said only occasionally, right? This honey's inside of cardboard, which is kind of weird, right? Is it gonna, I trust that it's going to come out when I squeeze. I just don't want to be surprised if it doesn't. And sort of want to do this now. I did, yeah. Oh, there it goes. There is a hole in the top a little bit. I think we need more of a hole in the top. Let me get my scissor. That honey's definitely coming out for sure now. I can see it. I'll just leave my scissor there. All right, oh yeah, these beans are definitely ready. So, we're going to add the honey, half the vinegar because we messed up, and half a cup of water. All right, honey, come out. Get out. Get out. You can. Oh, look, it's like a solid block of like real bees honey. Look at that. That's why we guess we need the water to help break that honey down. Oh man, honey, bean, garlic. This is, you can just tell how good this is going to be. No wonder this won a contest on a cooking show. It's all the most delicious foods. Okay, that's enough honey. It was honey. Remaining, oh, half the vinegar, right? Okay. Honey. And the water. And salt and pepper. Salt, pepper. Okay. 5 to 7 minutes on this one. Oh man, the timing is so good. Look, that one's got 5 minutes left. We should probably stir it. Oh man, actually the butter onion's looking super good right now over here. Whoa, that butter onion. Caramelized onion technically, but you know. Got 8 minutes left on the pork in the oven. You got 5 minutes left on each of these on the stove. So we're going to go 5 to 7 minutes or until the liquid has been reduced in volume by 3/4. Okay. The liquid's definitely reducing here. Let's just read ahead so we don't make any more mistakes, like forgetting to vinegar the onions. to the pan of beans, add the onion. So we're going to take the onion and the beans and combine them, both things on the stove. We're going to take 1/4 of the cilantro, add that in too. Stir that up. Then we're going to, I guess we were a little too fast. The pork was supposed to be out and rested. Let's see, once the pork is done, where does it say about resting the pork? Remove from the oven, transfer to the cutting board, and let rest for at least 5 minutes. Okay. So I guess our timing is actually a little bit, we went too fast. We should have let the pork be in the oven a little longer before we started moving on these other things. It's okay. Everything will work out fine. It's plenty warm in here. Nothing's going to get cold. So what we're going to be doing, we're just going to mix these together, plate them, and put the sliced pork on top. Pretty simple. And then garnish with the remaining cilantros. Getting close to done here. Oh, onion's done. Turn the heat off on that. And this is probably good. Turn off the heat. All right, to the pan of beans, add the onion and a quarter of the cilantro. Let's do that. Taking the two delicious things and combining. Man, this side part might be even more delicious than the pork, right? That's just a piece of pork with some spice rub on it. But this is like, oh, man, you got sugar in here and honey and whew. All right, you're done. You're done, timer. Okay. Oh, quarter of the cilantro. Boop. Added. Stir that up. Okay. Now all we really gotta do is get that pork out of there in a couple minutes. And we will be good to go. But then we have to wait. The pork's gotta rest for 5 minutes before we can slice it. All right. I don't wanna hear the oven noise, so. I'm going to stop the timer right now. Ooh, listen to those noises. Oh, I put these plates in the way. That's not good. Let's just put this right here. No, we're going to burn my cutting board. Let's put this over here. That's better. All right, we need to check the temperature. It said the inside temperature should be 145F. Bonk. That is way over 145F, I would say, right? 190, we good. I got a really hot oven, so that kind of thing happens. All right, we got to rest it for 5 minutes. Move it to the cutting board. Oh, no, we didn't mess up the vinegar. We're supposed to drizzle the onion with vinegar after we take it out. Aha! Hooray! Hooray! Drizzle the roasted onion, stir to coat, season with salt and pepper. All right. We didn't mess up. The onion does look a little burnt, though. Maybe that's because my oven's hot. Anyway, let's get a little bowl here. Let's make sure we get the timer for the... for letting the pork rest. I may have burnt this part. I'm not a pro. What do you want from me? Careful not to burn myself on that pan. Okay. Vinegar. All right, we didn't mess anything up at all like we thought we did. Salt, peppers. Okay. Oh, don't want to burn myself. Oh, actually not burning myself, as long as I take it easy. Mm-hmm. Mm. All right, well, let's start dividing the beans between two dishes. Cut the beans in half down the middle of the pan. Give more to me, less to Rip. That's the good part. I don't try to plate it nicely. Tastes the same. This isn't a fancy restaurant. Right? I'm hungry. I didn't eat lunch because I was doing this instead. Beans for me. Beans for you. Do the dishes later. This pan is way dirty. All right, slicing. Yeah. They said to slice against the grain. So where do you think the grain is? I think it's the grain goes this way, right? Which means we should slice this way, I think. I could be wrong. I actually don't know how to find the grain on meat, so that's awesome. That's definitely fully cooked, and it looks like we are clearly against the grain. You can see the grains are going, oh, I had it right. Good for me. That's slicing. Oh, it slices so nicely. I guess we're going to slice 100% of this meat, right? We're not going to, it's going to be half for me and half for you. It's fully cooked, right? Well, we had the thermometer, right? We know it's fully cooked. we made extra sure with the thermometer. Highly recommended purchase, the thermometer. Okay. Half? Come on. I can do it. I can do it. I did it. Can I do it again? Do I have these skills? This one might be easier. Look, fancy plating. Okay. Top with sliced pork and roasted onion. Half for you. Half for me. A little more for you. There you go. All right. And garnish with remaining cilantros. Half for you. Half for me. Okay. All right. Woo. Stand there holding the food like they do on TV. Yeah. All right, let's eat the food and see if it's any good. Fork. Oh, we probably need steak knives, right? Fork knife.
I'm going to keep this camera going.
There you go. All right. Is this delicious? Let's find out. Gonna taste the pork first, because that's, I guess, the main event, right? It's pretty good. It's definitely not dry. You can definitely get the spice rub is in every bite, because it's all over. You know, definitely excellent. Would not be disappointed if I ordered in a restaurant and got that. All right, let's taste the bean, the thing that I got the most expectations for, though. That bean. That bean. My expectations for the bean were very well met. All right, let's try the low expectation onion now. The burnt part didn't even really taste like, you know, sometimes you eat something that's burnt and you're like, oh, I ate a burnt thing. I did not experience that. That actually, onion is just fine. All right, so there you go. This is my contest entry for the Blue Apron. What's the recipe called again? Spice rubbed pork with sweet red onion and black bean. I cooked it. It tastes great. And now I just want to eat it and stop making videos now. So that's what we're going to do. All right, we done.